Welcome to Abundant Life Homestead. The other day we were watering Caleb's corn and the end of the hose popped off. It's not an uncommon thing to happen with old hoses. And this hose has been around a while. It's been spliced a couple times. We decided we really have more hose than we needed. One of our splices has been leaking anyway. So we're going to cut it back today to make two good hoses out of the one broken hose. And Caleb's going to learn how to put the ends on and stuff for us, okay? Sound like a plan? So you want to be as perpendicular as you can across that hose. And being perfect ain't going to happen, but...
Oh, we were way past the bubble.
Yeah.
Sure smells a little bit burned.
Yeah.
I set this down right next to the microphone. Is it plugged into that?
One's made for a cheaper hose with thinner walls. Get this started here.
Well, I said it was probably because it's too long, because someone might accidentally turn the camera on and just leave it on. Yeah. Forget about it. Probably to help protect the set.
Got it down to the second one. Yeah, well, we're putting a lot of strain on it. So. Yeah, pretty much on the end there.
Kind of turned a little.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of turned a little. Good to compress.
Mm-hmm. Don't squeeze it. Just don't squeeze it incredibly hard. And switch to the other side. Mm-hmm.
Squeeze it.
Remember, you just want it to get threaded, dude. You don't even want to feel it getting tight. Just start it threading through. Get them close to where they're threading and then move them in equally. Had a couple turns in them, but that's all right. Check the fitting first. Well, thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video, maybe even possibly learned something. And we appreciate it and hope you have a blessed night. Thank you.